went to Amelia Island, somebody's like, who hurt that chick? Who hurt that kid? Don't worry about
it. All right, hold up, Kenny.
You good?
I can see. I'm just trying to make sure I got you in the right position. So as long as...
What's our parameters?
Yep, as long as we are from the pink basket over, we're good.
Over to where?
No, all the way to the window.
Okay. So we just need to be like, if we're talking to the thing.
No, I mean, I'm good.
We're not at a...
You're mid-table. Angle. You're mid-table. I mean, yeah, you're at an angle because it's sideways, but it works.
Do we need to lift up any higher? You're gonna get higher.
It's fine.
Okay. It's live?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, y'all. Here we go. We're live. See if we can't get our music.
Hold up, yeah. Y'all got to get up on your feet. Come on, pass it around.
What did that do?
It helped to pay for our 10-year anniversary trip to Hawaii. We're going on in July. Nice.
It paid for like one night.
Well, that's fun. Hey, that's fun. All right, and my neutral Rebecca is not here. She actually had almost an $800 training show. So, y'all, you guys, that's huge. It already paid back like a third of her investment, or no, like half of her investment. She paid off just at her training show. So that right there is awesome. She's super pumped. And she didn't realize she had a show tonight. So it's her first show, and I was like, oh, bad mom. Like, did I really not put that on your calendar? So we know moving forward, coming to training is more important than the show, but this time it'll slap. If you just put them on your calendar in advance, so you don't accidentally do that. But we're really excited. So Barbara had $755. Did that do something for your family? All right, we paid it off.
My investment in the business.
All right.
We'll pay on that.
Yay. And then Jessica, $695. That was exciting. Woo! And then Michelle's not here. She had one over $600 also. And then I have some ladies in the house. Barbara had one over $1,120 show. Woo! Would that make a difference in your life to go out and do a show that there's the possibility it can be huge? Okay, so that can be really life changing. Sabrina, I gotta give her a shout out. Girl, if you're watching live, or awesome Sabrina, $1,788 show, y'all. And that was a fundraiser. So that's awesome. And now, does she just split her profit?
Yes.
So she's blessed.
Yes.
And they're blessed. Yo, so that is why I love doing fundraisers, because you split an $1,800 show. You know, you're looking at, they make half and you make half of that cut, and so you're still making great money to then bless someone else. So fundraisers are always worth your time to give back. All right, and then we got Christy. She had $1,064. Y'all, $500, like in your pocket to go
pay
the jewelry.
Helped pay for an AC unit.
Okay. Oh. Yes. Yes. And then I saved the best, well, not the best for last, but there's some kickback on this one. So Tammy's got somebody. Iris had a $1,257 show.
Okay. Iris, stand up. I wanted Iris to share this because this is so, so exciting. I didn't even tell her this yet, but anyway, it should be very obvious. Iris started this business after 6 years of back and forth with me. We just kept running into each other, you know. But it was God's perfect timing. She loves this business and wants to do it as a ministry, but she had something that was a necessity in her life. She was able to get her new car so she can travel safely.
On Saturday and walked out with a brand new car.
That's a God thing, y'all, yeah. Because it's not, sometimes people, it's not a matter of, well, I just can't afford a new car, this, that, other. Sometimes you cannot afford and you have to drive it no matter what. Mm-hmm. And Premier has given her the way to be able to have a safe vehicle. Mm-hmm. And it's awesome. Beautiful, awesome. Too.
Thank you.
Oh, I didn't see it. I have to come look at it. Okay. So that's awesome. So I just wanted to share the blessing that, you know, even if you're taking the time to do 1 to 2 shows a month, whatever your family needs, wherever your need is, just know you can do that. You know, I chose to do 10 shows this past month and the other, you know, January and February. Like, I'm going to be slowing down moving into, you know, the summer just because that's where our life is right now in Stephen's crazy schedule. Okay, I'll be trying to do a lot of Facebook parties just so I can do something. But, you know, life happens. And so that is the beauty. If
you really, will you go scold him, please?
Can you tell him up
now?
She's
like,
I'm not going to get over that. Side business comes in for us, and you can do it at whatever level. And this is just proof
on how you attach it to bills and things in your life, you can see the value that it's doing. Anybody else have anything that Premier did and paid for them that made a difference in their month? Anybody else have anything to share?
They paid my phone bills.
Yes.
Yay!
I recently quit my job to go full time with Premier, and I mean, it's like I've go off of the deep end. And in all honesty, I'm just going to be real with you. My phone was about to be turned off, and I had a show, and I was able to pay my phone bill and keep my phone on.
Praise God. Yes. And I love that we get paid immediately, y'all.
Yeah.
And so, just really quick, so I never really thought about this. A lot of people always ask, why can't we order online? And someone shared with me, if for some reason Premier were to take our catalog online, then all the money would go to Premier. We'd have to wait to get a paycheck. And that's why, another reason, we don't want that. We are blessed to be paid on the spot. Everything goes to us. So thankfully we have the online viewing, but that is something I didn't know, so I just wanted to share that with y'all.
You need that personal touch with your people.
Yes, absolutely. Huge.
Y'all want to eliminate that.
Yes.
Yes. And I guess a lot of you, and we'll bring this up later, but if you've noticed, if you're trying to do Facebook shows, you may have a good one here and there, but they are nothing like a personal show. So do not try to have your business off of Facebook events.
Lord, no.
At all. Okay. All right. We've got some recognitions.
Oh, and recognitions. Yep. Yeah, Sammy's going to take this one over.
Okay. We want the stand-ups, too, because we have some goodies here.
Yes.
Okay.
So I was just going to do the tops for those.
Okay.
So Barbara had our top most shows for the month of March. She had 6.
Woo!
Okay. Easter Sunday, y'all. We got to keep in the, Okay, and then our top show, Sabrina is not here, and so number 2, Iris. Alright, so those are, and then retail, our top retail was also Barbara with 3,213. Okay, so that makes a huge difference. All right, and then there is another special recognition that Tammy's going to do. Barb, come on up here.
Barb is, the Lord has blessed me too, and I will just share because y'all know that I'm not trying to make this about Tammy, but this is a praise, so I want to, give the story about it. Anyway, so my life has been all over. Y'all know I'm the roller coaster, and Judy's been around long enough to, just ride the wave. Anyway, and she hasn't left me yet, so we're good. But over the last year or so, life with my health got really crazy, and so the Lord slowed my business down intentionally. I mean, I did all this 10-show jump for years. And it's not easy, but it's a season of life, and when you're able to do that, your family needs it, that's what you do.
Right.
But anyway, as far as my business, we had to literally just slow down so to survive. And when God slows your business down for whatever reason in your life, just trust that he's still in it, okay? And so I just continued swimming just to try to keep my head above water, and I had a sponsoring lull for 8 months. Did not sponsor anyone for 8 months. Well, that may not be a big deal for some, but for me, I always sponsor. I'm, 1 to 2, a month. But anyway, so I trusted God, it's fine, everything's good. And then the Lord opened the door in January, and I sponsored Barb. We had actually met in November at her first jewelry show, but the Lord opened the door for me with Barb, and then subsequently several thereafter, but Barb was that very first one, that connection, and, I'd only known Barb for a few months, but there was a specialness about Barb, and she loved the Lord, and she was just loving on me through the process, and she'd only known me for a couple months, and I just thought, wow, what an amazing person that just, developing relationships with people is so big, and so Barb came and said, I'm ready to do this, and I am so proud of her because... Y'all, she came in your training
Mommy,
show at the end of January.
Mommy,
something
Mommy.
Like that.
February, actually. It was in February.
Okay. But anyway, whatever it was. So she has accomplished her quick start 6.
Yeah.
My one
still working the other.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so she's in the process of doing Quick Start 9, and I just wanted to kind of share with you why this is a big deal. You know, we're really pulling for her to get this up. Not because, oh yeah, it comes with free jewelry. Oh yeah, it comes with an award. But because she has really worked her tail off to try to make this work. And she doesn't have a huge family here in the state. She's from Virginia.
None.
And so she has, it's us, you know. So I said, this is now your family. And she's been working at every angle she can. And she's been using the Facebook as a way. And I'm going to get her to do some training, not tonight, but we're going to get her to do some training because she came on and started her own premier Facebook group. And I'm telling you, you would think she's been around for years.
Yes.
Watching her. But about the time she came in, Iris came in too, and they both go to the same church and were splitting the same friends, and which was fine. But you all know this, when that happens, okay, you're even more in your little box. But she has not allowed any of this to stop her. She's continued to work her business. She did a show in Virginia via Facebook. Is that the one that just qualified? Just qualified to make her a show. And she did an event the other night on Facebook, last week actually.
Right.
And we're waiting on that. She still did it within her time frame, so she's got the date. We just have to hit the 100 to close it out, and she will have hit her 9.
Woo!
So she has worked every single angle and not given up, and I'm so very proud of her for doing that. So I wanted to congratulate you on that. Every one of you can do it, but I also want you to remember, if you work your business and you give it everything you have and it doesn't happen, it does not make you a failure.
Mm-hmm.
It does not. Go for your goals. Shoot for the moon, land among the stars, okay? If it's meant to be, it'll happen. If it's not, you're learning something along the way. Just continue to work. But on top of that, Barb has worked so hard, and this month she was the most shows, top retailer, awesome.
Yay.
And, y'all, did I mention that she's got a new baby, too? A premier baby?
Yep.
So you, my dear, are now the Diamond Diva.
Oh my goodness.
Tonight it would have gone to someone else.
Ah.
And this is why I wanted to make it.
She kept messing. Are you sure you can't come? I said I got family. Maybe you need to bring them with you. You're gonna be here. I'm like, okay, we're going.
So you will be our guest at that tea in January next year. And ladies, y'all want to be there. So just actively work your business, and you never know, it could be you too, because you can only be one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, you can only be named one, so that gives everybody plenty of time to get on there. Okay?
Yeah.
I'm the Diva. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. All right. Just get some paper. All right. So I'm going to do our devotional. You know, I was... looking for something. This whole training is about planting seeds and learning how to sow and water and love on it until you reap a harvest. And so this morning I was trying to find what I thought would be a really good devotional to kind of go along with it. And I love Joan's keeping it personal. Joan was one of our founders, Andy's wife. She passed away in December of 10. But she is still with us in spirit, and I just love the way she put down her thoughts. And so I was not able to use today's, but I looked back a little bit and found something that I just thought was perfect for tonight. So it's called Newness Blooming and Springing Forward. It says, in Dallas, when the jonquils finish blooming and the blue bonnets begin to appear, we know springtime is near. I love this season of year and the new hope and freshness it promises. Maybe for you the present seems dreary and you are not excited about the future. Isaiah 43:19 is for you. As God says, see, I am doing a new thing. Wouldn't you love to do a new thing? Forget the disappointments in your work, the postponed meetings, the missed goals, whatever. It doesn't matter. God is going to do a new thing. What a great promise this is. Later on in the same chapter of Isaiah, the Lord reminds the Israelites that they had refused to ask for his help. Stubborn people, you say. But are we any different? Those of us who believe in God and yet try to function on our own displease the Lord. The result is not functioning at all. Spring, summer, fall, winter. Most parts of the country experience these seasonal changes in weather every year. We experience seasons in our lives too. In the Old Testament book of Ruth, we read that Naomi and her two daughters-in-law, Ruth and Orpah, all three women lost their husbands. Naomi wanted to move back to her homeland, and she told her daughters to remain there in their own land. The young women suddenly faced a tough decision. Orpah decided to stay home, to stay in her comfort zone. Ruth boldly decided to follow Naomi to a new land. Ruth ventured into a new season of life full of risks, yes, but also of new possibilities. Just as the spring rains bring tiny pink buds, little white flowers, and green blades of grass, so these women found new hope after a hard, barren season in their lives. Maybe you have gone through a personal challenge in your life recently, illness, financial setback, hard decisions. I encourage you to take a step into a new spring. Spring always brings change. The choices you make in your springtime will impact your life for years to come. Let's take heart in the new season of beautiful flowering things. Let's ask God for wisdom to use the gifts he has given us. And let's believe God will do this new thing. And from Jeremiah 5:24, God gives us rain each spring and fall, assuring us of plentiful harvest. Isn't that awesome? Mm-hmm.
That was Jeremiah what?
25:4. Or, sorry, 5:24. I just love that because it is so, so true. And I preach about that all the time, about the seasons of your life and don't give up. Galatians 6:9 is my verse, I say, because it talks about not growing weary and doing good. And y'all probably heard me say that a million times, but I say it because it's so very important to our, not only our lives, but to our businesses. Don't grow weary in doing good, because if you continue on, you will reap a harvest in due time. It's God's timing for our lives that we are going to reap that benefit. So don't quit. And if you watched this week, I posted in the event, and it was saying, and Canoe, didn't you say something about that? It was perfect timing for you. Even if it hits one person, y'all, if you see those motivational things, put them out there. Because perhaps Candy or I aren't inspired for that day, or Judy hasn't found something that day. But if you see something that you know is going to encourage one of your fellow sisters, post that. Just don't quit because you are on the brink of something amazing. Okay? I just want to open us up in a word of prayer before we do get started. So, Lord God, thank you so much for this beautiful, beautiful day you've given us today. A perfect example of the beauty of nature and just, Lord, the blessings that are around us. God, I thank you for filling this room full tonight, Lord. There is definitely a harvest going on right now in our Premier family. Lord, we're so grateful for each life that is here and that is being touched. And Lord, I just pray that tonight's training will actually help these ladies, Lord, to see in themselves the true potential that you have given them, Lord, and that they find the direction you choose for their life and they follow it, Lord. God, we just thank you for your blessings and pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, if y'all will turn off your cell phones, and I'm going to pass around. This is the prayer journal for tonight. So if you'll just put your name and your jeweler number on here with your prayer request. If you don't want it to be seen, put unspoken. We have an awesome prayer ministry that prays for us. I've used Jan a lot lately. And she is just absolutely amazing. We had a family emergency. We had I posted about that, and
we don't typically discuss those types of details because it is that personal. Thank you. See, I need help with my words. See, Judy, it's not all you now. Barb's picking up. Judy's always got my back. I mean, that's what we get. And it's called fibromyalgia. Screws up your brain. Anyway, and I'm just rolling with it, okay? As long as I've got people to cover me.
There you go.
Anyway, so it's very personal, so we didn't go into all the details and whatnot, but I was able to call Jen when I was with my sister on Friday night when we were at the hospital with her, and, you know, and just be able to cry to her, and she understood, and, you know, and she stood there in the middle of her night out with a group of friends that I knew she was with. She stopped and prayed for me and took that time and has already checked on us twice asking. So
she's a rock.
She doesn't just, hey, this is Jan, let me pray for you. She knows the details of our lives and loves us. So if you are feeling concerned about releasing any of that to her, don't. Mm-hmm. She can lift you in so many ways. So, but if you're concerned about letting us know anything about it, you are welcome to put unspoken. I'm telling you, it's just the way it is. All right, so Andy's up next.
So I am going to be covering planting seeds of love and building relationships. So this is important. Did anybody watch the Sunday Sisters training last night? Brandy Lynn?
Yeah.
Yes?
Some of it, yeah.
Some of it. Anybody else? Okay. Y'all, go back and watch it. That's y'all's homework for sure. But you can never get too much training, especially when it comes from Brandy Lynn. But I can't hold you. Mommy got a mommy here. The doggy outside in the fence. My kid is afraid of dogs, so you know you can take your kids everywhere, but mine got bit at the show, so he no longer likes animals. He's a little fearful of a dog now. So. Anyways, so here's the thing with building relationships. Tammy touched on it with, you know, just the way she's already built relationship with Barb in just a few months and just what that has been able to do. So you're going to, I'm going to talk through just kind of what seeds are and how we plant them in our premier business. Because when you think about regular seeds in your garden and things like that, you've got to put them into good soil, right? You can't just throw them out there on some like hard dirt and expect them to grow. What do they need to grow?
Water.
Light. Okay. Nutrients, yes. So those are things that you have to put into your business as well. And so when you're sharing with someone, you can't just share the business, you know, your tools. So I found this to kind of put it into perspective. So what the seeds are, they're the actual tools we have to share our premier opportunity. So whether you're sharing your personal testimony, what Premier has done for you, or if you're new and you don't know how to start all that yet, you know, we've got different video links all over YouTube. Your Premier, if you have a personal website, there's a link with Mandy Eaton. She is in our marketing department. She's got a wonderful video that people can access through our personal website. They can watch an opportunity presentation on our website. They can fill out the questionnaire afterwards. That way you kind of know where they stand with any questions or any, you know, what level of interest they're at. So that's another great thing you can use. Another tool, which are seeds of getting the information out there, you can use your last 10 home show sheets, showing people the true money. That's why I wanted to share with actual shows you ladies held and what that's done for your family. Our closeout sheets, hopefully everybody uses them, but you leave the closeout sheet for the hostess that night and it says, hey, if you were the jeweler tonight, you would have made this much money, because it's planting seeds. But here's the thing, if you don't turn around and share the business with that hostess, and you never told her, by the way, you could have made all the profit tonight, then you're missing out on planting. You might have sprinkled the seeds or planted the seeds, but you're not watering them, you're not fertilizing them, and you're not giving them what they need to grow. So in this business, the key is going to be following up. You've got to be able to share, number one. If you're not sharing, you're missing out. That's where the planting of the seeds is coming. You can do everything in the world, like we talk about. You can put everything out there, and then if God doesn't make it work, at, you know, whatever point in your life, that's fine. That may not be the case. But if you are not putting in the work and the effort, then it may be on you. You can't blame it on God if something's not working. You got to look and say, did I truly put in what I needed to make my business work, you know, I want it to be? And so that is something to really think about. And so I watched last night's video. I was really bummed because I was like, oh my gosh, she's live and I missed the live. But I love me some Brandy Lynn, so I was like, I want to be on her live. And so I was like upset. Well, you know what? I had a crazy day today. Do you know when I listened to that video? It's like a 40-minute video. That girl talks as much as I do. Okay? So it was like 40, 50 minutes worth of a video. So I dropped Dylan off at preschool, and I listened to it the entire way to the gym, sat in the parking lot until I had like 4 minutes to get in the door and be on the floor. And then I got back in the car, and I turned it back on, and I listened to it the rest of my way home, and I listened to the last 4 minutes in my driveway. Because you fit it into the nooks and crannies. I can listen and drive. Like, I don't even hear the radio. I wanted that information in my head because it's like that much of an impact on our business. Because what she was sharing was on prospecting and on exactly this topic that I really think everybody needs to go back and listen to, because she really hit on some wonderful strategic verbiage that she uses.
How much of that was from GoPro?
GoPro, yes. So a lot of it's from GoPro, and a lot of it is... Yes, and so a lot of us, there's a group that we're doing a GoPro No Excuses group right now. I will do another one probably in the fall, so if you're interested in that, let me know. But it's wonderful information. If you just want to pick up that book and read it, I'm telling you, it will change your business. But yes, so a huge, huge, huge amount of it came from that. So here's what she says, though. You want to make a prospect list outside of your shows, and you want to list 10 people. So here's the thing. If you don't have these people to love on and to follow up with and to build relationships with, you're not going to have a business. So you have to make a prospect list and have a running one at all times. So people, these were some people she said she, you know, pulls from outside of an actual show. But like any past hostesses you can think of. So if you've been in a while and you're struggling to where to get your people from, call your past hostesses, any stay-at-home moms. Millennials was a big one. She said these people want to be entrepreneurs. I fall into that category. Just who? But they said like 82-ish. I'm like, I'm 82. All right. So retirees, fashionistas, sports moms, corporate women who just need something fun to do, you know, people that need extra money and something on the side. But here's what you have to understand. When we're sharing these seeds and these tools, you have to make sure you're strategic in what you're doing. Listen to a few of the videos. Listen to which one, you know, a phone call or whatever, if there's a phone number one, if there's a video one. Make sure they're going to cater to what that person's explaining is going to cater to the person you're sharing with. Or make sure when you personally share one-on-one, you relate it to their life. When I was talking to Jessica, I make sure I explain to her how it can fit into her life. It does her no good to know, okay, yes, it's great to know, it's been great for you, but I always like to pull the reason, you know, and she may or may not, but she's a single mom. So I'm like, oh my gosh, y'all, if you've been around, y'all know this is one of the huge reasons Premier was even founded, you know, for single moms to have a way to make some extra money and to make great money without being gone for a long time from the house. And so that was huge, and I made sure she knew that. So if you don't cater and plant those seeds and follow up and water them the right way, you're really going to miss out. And so I love those different things. And then at a show, you always need to be listening. Because if you're not listening for those people that have a need or they show interest or they are that fashionista, you know, those are the people you're looking at to pull up to do the opportunity presentation. Not the opportunity, but like your sponsoring activity during the show. So go back though for sure and watch that. Because she makes it very clear it's not going to be a one and done. I love that. I'm like, amen. It's not a one and done. Air Force is the same exact thing in his GoPro book. You cannot expect this type of business for someone to walk up and sign up the first time they hear about it.
Unless you're Kenny.
Unless you're me. Because I was like, oh, where do I sign? And Brooke was like, let me just make you dinner. You can come over. That's when we have paper contracts. And I was like, all right, whatever. So I was that long person. But I just needed some extra money. It sounded good to me. but you want to build a relationship. And so if you are already annoyed or irritated that it didn't work out, you shared the information and they were like, nope. Did you do what you needed to do to follow up with the love and with the relationship building and truly being more invested in how it's going to affect them than how it's going to affect you? Because it doesn't make any difference how it affects you. Because it's not about you, it is about them. And we have a gift in Premier, and if we can work this business, it works. And so if we can show people how to do that, and that's why Premier is sponsoring and not recruiting. We are not a numbers game. It makes no difference for me to go out and sign up 15 people next month. Zero. It doesn't help me at all. I got to go do 15 shows, I got to train 15 people, and I got to do all the same thing, and I want to make sure I train them properly. So Premier wants to make sure we have the ability to do that. That's also why they pay us to train the people. They want us invested, and they want us to do that. And so you really have to be intentional when you friend people on Facebook, and you know you're building relationships with them, like their stuff, comment on their things, be authentic, be genuine, like be real, and truly care about other people, and make it more about building that relationship and sharing the opportunity, getting the information in their hands, and God will do the rest. But you have to constantly set up the next meeting. You have to constantly set up the next opportunity and keep those seeds watered and fertilized so they can grow. Because if not, if we were to say, hey, it's a good idea, but, you know, never reach back out, they're not going to call you and say, yeah, I just been thinking about it and done my research. And unless they're just that person, they're going to just be like, something else is going to come around. Someone else is going to push harder. Someone else is going to follow up harder. And then they may end up in something that they shouldn't have. And they could have been with a company that pays 50% with no hassle, no stress, and whatever. We have the amazing, amazing benefits that we do for the flexibility. And so we are, you know, we need to do that. And we owe these people that we're meeting at our shows the truth and what it looks like and what they can have if they just come in here and they work this business at whatever level they want. If they're working it, it's going to pay a bill or whatever. Y'all saw tonight, these people that did shows in March, what it affected their family. You know, you can pay a phone bill, you can pay an airline ticket. You know, we get to do extra fun things sometimes with this type of business. Brandy said on her training, she started this business 6 years ago for $200 a month. Now she's working it full-time and staying home full-time, you know, making crazy money. But you have to look at that. I did print out some random, let's see what it's like. Hold on. Oh, the prospects are going, and so a prospect is anyone that may be interested, you know, in the business that you're sharing with. It's just a list of prospects. You want to just kind of have like this running list of people that you might could have a show for, or you might feel they're interested. She said she pulls people from her Facebook that mentions losing a job or needing something, whatever. She puts them on her list. So then you have people to constantly follow up with, constantly try to put in front of the information. You do not have to convince anyone to sign up for Premier. Premier is awesome. We know that are in it. And if someone wants it, that's fine. You don't have to like convince them and break their arm for it. You just have to share the information. The information and the actual numbers of the shows, when you do them, produce like the reality of like, it's phenomenal. I still can't believe I get paid to do this. So, and neither can Steve, and he's like, whatever. But, he's like, he's seen me one time, he's like, you talk about all your friends over here and over here. I'm like, they are my friends, like my hostesses. I'm like, no, they're my friends. Like, this one lady, she's awesome. Like, we went to, you know, lake together, we went shopping together. You know, like, they've become my friends and, like, you know, like a side family. Like, I love my customers and hostesses. And that's what you have to build and that's what you have to create. Because then they trust you and then they know. And you know you're not lying to them. Like, some of these MLM companies and things like that, that's where people have fear. And you got to understand, with rightly so. They have the right. Steven got involved in one at one point. So, anyway, it was one of them companies that people are fearful of. And so, thankfully, we have something that comes without the quotas and all that nightmare. And we have founders that just love and care about us. So, we need to do the same. And then, let's see. I did write notes because I always don't follow them. They need to be around it more than once. Let's see. And then you can't think of it as a no. Like, so someone just says, hey, not right now, or I need to follow up, or, you know, I need to think about it. You want to stay in contact every 24 to 48 hours, kind of like staying in contact as far as that goes, I think, or have the next meeting set up, because otherwise a negative Nancy can get involved and get in somebody's ear. That's not going to work because it didn't work for them. But you know what? Ask them, well, did you work it? Well, probably not. And a lot of people, if you really truly talk them through a business that they might have gotten, they might not have actually worked it. So think about that. But you just have to stay in contact. Find some type of follow-up system, whatever it may be. But you have to, Tammy's going to talk about harvesting your crops and things like that. And that's going to be one of the main things that you're wanting to do. I have found huge, huge, huge value in Facebook, having that Facebook family of my customers and hostesses to really build within that. And just have a relationship with them, have fun with them, different random things. So that's really added value, I think, to my customers. And I try to keep it as personal as possible because that's what Premier wants. And that's what we're all about. Alright, hey May.
Y'all, just because I'm making fun of myself today. So, part of my fibro fog crap is that I can't find things all the time. And I'm like looking for the same thing over and over. So I was running all over the house, y'all, looking for my phone. Where's my phone?
Right here.
You just been like check in the back pocket, and I'm running.
I do that, and I don't have
that. I do that.
I do it. Yes. But as I told my dad when he says you just got a lot on your plate, it is not like that. It is so much deeper and more ridiculous. So I just laugh. But there's a laugh with myself now. So thanks. And I have people do things for me.
That's a sister's support.
That's right. Okay. So now I don't know what time it is, if I'm on time, what I'm doing.
Well, we're a little behind, but
okay.
We always catch up. So.
Yeah. Okay. So what I wanted to do is show everybody how easy it is to share our blessing. Okay? Nobody should have an excuse that they aren't sharing the blessing of Premier at all. And I'm going to let you do something fun in a minute. Can you see this? Doesn't that look fun? I went and got it just because I knew you were bored. I'm telling you. Oh, isn't she great for just sitting here watching us grown up doing our thing? Awesome. Okay. So,
lady in training.
That's right.
Yes. Jordan lady in training, she said. Anyway, so what is one reason you don't share Premier? Y'all be honest.
You're scared?
I mean, speaking to strangers.
Speaking to strangers, what else?
Somebody's going to say no. That's
you're prejudging.
Do you worry about rejection, Sam?
Sometimes I feel like I don't know all the right information.
Right. Okay. You can't think of it on the spot.
Right. So I'm going to show y'all how easy this is, and everybody can do this. And so I picked the simplest way to do it, okay? And it's 5 pages, y'all. Can we manage that?
Yep.
Okay, we can manage that. So what I did is found a fun little template. It's called 2 plus 2 plus 2. Is that not the easiest? Okay. You agree?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So it's as simple as 2 plus 2 plus 2. So I'm just going to walk through it. Jessica can hear it. Tamara can hear it, you know, because y'all aren't familiar with Premier. So you get to actually hear. And as for all of you jewelry ladies, this will help you to know how easy this is. So y'all can just do it for yourself. And we will have this uploaded. When I pass it around, just so you can look at it, there are going to be some noticeable things in here that y'all be like, that doesn't sound right. Because this was long before our boutique was there and before we updated our bonus structure. So, but that it's not a big enough deal for me to not use this tonight. I wanted to let y'all see it. And then we will correct the PDF and upload it to the Diamond Diva site. So all you have to do is print it, take it to a show and say, hey, I'm in training. Let me just go through this real quick with you. That way you have the information in case you know somebody. That is the easiest way to do that without making anyone feel pressure. You never know when you share what's going to happen. Remember, like she said, it doesn't happen overnight. You're just sharing. Okay? So this is
are you doing?
Judy looks like...
She's named your steps. Are you named steps?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Judy's back there on the chair dance. What are you doing?
I have my other goals.
She needs more steps.
Mine just buzzed it.
Oh my gosh, that's funny.
No. Just eat better.
See, she's going. She's aiming for goals.
Okay, so Premier Designs. This is easy as 1, 2, 3.
Actually, 2 plus 2 plus 2. I gotta remember that. I gotta get my ad lib out.
I've been doing this for almost 10 years. Okay, Premier Designs Jewelry. Two things that Premier does to help you with your business. The Golden Guarantee, the company backs you up. Our hostess plan, it keeps you in business. Your cost away to give away 30% in free jewelry is just $8. And your cost to give away each bonus is just $6. And those bonuses are going to help you build your business. There are two ways to make money in our business. One is showing and selling the jewelry, and your profit's 50%. You get paid at the time you sell your jewelry. The second way is by sponsoring people into this business. Premier is going to pay you 10% on 3 levels down. So see the cute little picture of the hearts? This is you, and you have children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. All of those, you make 10% on those people. Okay? There are two costs to help you to start your business. The first one is $395 for your license to become a jeweler, and you get a complete office staff at your service. You get supplies and literature to get you going. So some of the supplies we're going to get are we're going to get our catalog, order form, training materials, business in a box. And then some of the services that we get, which I would pay this in a heartbeat, is they do with all the accounting for us. We don't have to worry about if we have our Premier family. I don't have to call you and say, how much did you do? Y'all do what you need to do. Premier will tell me what y'all did when they nicely give me a check because we are working to help you. The same thing happens for you when you have a family. They also take care of all that shipping, packing, delivery. Have you gotten an order with Premier?
No.
Okay. But it's awesome because all your little boxes come all nicely done. And then they are wrapped together with the customer's order. The whole inventory is listed there. Premier takes care of all that for us. And that's just a couple of things that they do. And then they, the jewelry samples that we're going to display, we have an option to get those if we want to. It is not required. But as you know, if you want some shoes in your shoe store, you need to have shoes, not a catalog. Okay? So same thing with your jewelry store. So you have an opportunity to just get your jewelry at half cost. 50%, and then you can also purchase our awesome boutique. Who has the boutique and loves it? Those are pre-selected pieces that Premier does for you of the top sellers for that quarter, and so you have fabulous pieces on your table that's selling like that, you know, selling like hotcakes. So you get a kit that has 30 plus pieces. It has all the table setups to make it look like a beautiful storefront boutique. And it's only $475 for a value of $1,300 worth of product. Isn't that amazing? Premier does great for us. So, that's it. $395 to start your business. That allows you to do your business anywhere in the United States and have no territories. And then your boutique at $475. So, it's as simple as 2 plus 2 plus 2 equals 6. You need to do 6 jewelry shows to pay back your investment. Well, you know what? When this was done, our investment was $1,200. Our investment now is basically $9. So, how about 4 or 5 shows? Isn't that great? That is as simple as it is. Could y'all do that on a show?
Sure.
Could you say, hey ladies, I'm going to do a prize drawing with a charm bracelet or anything you want to give away. Something simple. And say, hey ladies, I'm going to do a prize drawing afterwards for anybody that will give me 5 minutes to share a little bit about Premier. And all of a sudden, how many women have you just shared the business with that you never had to set up a time to set up that opportunity presentation on your own? You didn't have to make phone calls to try to share the opportunity. You just shared it with the ladies that were right there in front of you. And the ones that are interested, you make an appointment with them afterwards. Very, very simple. So I'm going to pass this around and let you see it. And because we have a few extra minutes and I want to have some fun,
because I knew one of our guests was getting antsy. I thought this would be fun, and y'all need to see it anyway, okay? There's a lot of new jewelers in here, and when I first started, this was the funnest thing. Was this not the most fun thing ever?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Barb, we're going to let you come up,
okay?
And Barb is our jewelry lady. Okay, so I need you to stand right here, okay? And this is going to show you a representation of what it looks like to build a premier family, how easy it is, and that way you can have a visual of what your business can be, because if you're doing jewelry shows, as most of us, we are busy women. We all shaking our head. Mm-hmm. We can only do so many shows, no matter how many days a month there are. There's still only 30, 31 days in a month if you did one every day. You don't. But you can only do so much. But with building your business, you have more control over building a future for yourself. It's going to have a larger income, okay? So Barb is our jewelry lady, and she is loving for me. So Barb.
True so far.
During the month, okay? How many jewelry shows, we're just going to say, we're going to do four months. Okay, so for her month, she's going to do four jewelry shows, which is one a week. That's pretty easy to do, okay? So, at each jewelry show, what is our average jewelry show? Anybody know? $400, and we make 50%. So how much does Barb make at her show?
$800.
She makes $800 a show. I like that.
All the shows together.
She does.
You're right.
Yeah, that's right. So she's doing it four a month, so she gets $200 at each show. So here's $500.
That's okay.
Six, seven, you make $800.
Okay.
You love what you're doing, don't you?
I do.
Okay. Well, now Barb is having such a good time, she wants to build her business, so she's going to have her own jewelry lady, okay? So pick a jewelry lady.
All right.
Is that who you want me to be?
Marley. I got your mama's name because that's mine. So Marley is going to be her jewelry lady, okay? This is your premier daughter. Now, Marley, I know you're busy with school and things, okay? But if you were doing premiere, how many shows would you want to do in your month? You would want to do four often? Good. Smart woman. That's right. Okay. So you are going to make some good money, too. So she also made $200 each show. So she made $800. Well, now, Barb is really working to help her. As premier moms, that's what we do. It's not about just collecting a check from somebody. We don't recruit, they just collect.
We support.
We sponsor loving and serving, okay? So Premier pays us 10% for doing that. So if she's made $800, how much is Barb gonna earn? She makes $80, okay? So Barb, 20, 40, 60, $80, okay? Now, Marley, you're having a blast too, right? Don't you want to have a premier baby? Okay, who do you want to have a premier baby? Okay.
Jesus, family affair.
That's right. Now, Marley, I don't know anything about your life, if it's crazy busy or you have all the time in the world. I don't know. How many jewelry shows would you like to do?
Seven.
Wow.
That's my girl.
Well, now, seven jewelry shows times $200 each is...
$14.
And we're just saying this because these are average numbers. So you took all my 500s. Nope, there's no 11, 12, 13, $1,400. Woohoo, she's in one.
Woo!
Are you locked out? Leave her out there! Okay, so she's made $1,400. Well, Marley is her mom in Premier. So Marley, we're all backwards. No, we are so backwards.
Go home and try to explain this to people.
Yeah. So Marley is going to make 10% of what Tamara just made. So that's $140, okay? So here is 100.
I like that a lot.
20 and 40. But you know what? The grandma also gets paid. Because grandma's also helping, okay? So you're going to get $140.
I can't hold all this money. I need to go spend some.
Okay. Now, Tamara, aren't you having a ball?
Yes.
Okay, oh, rolling in the money. Don't you want to have some premier babies?
I do.
Okay, pick a baby.
We have a family now.
I choose Iris because I remember her name.
in Christ.
Yes.
Right?
Okay, Iris.
Come over here.
You're her baby, not mine.
Okay. Now, Iris, I know you're crazy busy.
Yes.
So maybe 2 shows this month.
Okay? All right. Jeannie, come on up. looking great.
Cool. Where'd you go?
Myrtle Beach.
Did you have to make a reservation?
Last minute, yes.
Last minute? Okay. Yeah. Who else went away?
Me.
Where'd you go?
California.
California. Okay. Was it just you or family too?
Just me and my husband.
Okay. That's family. We don't tell him. Did you have to make reservations?
No, just stay with family.
Okay. How far in advance did you buy your tickets?
3 months.
3 months. So you planned out your trip. Okay. How far in advance did you?
Just a day.
Just a day.
Okay. For a moment.
And were you thinking about it? Right? Whether what shoes you were wearing, what clothes you were wearing, what was going with what. And we all know what kind of shoes he had to.
Yeah. You know, by accident, I brought 11 pairs and bought 12. Make number 12.
So you had to do whether it was last minute or it was a couple months in advance, you did some kind of prep for it, right? Okay. So, I'm going to show you a little bit of what you use that prep to help you with your fall, okay? Because I know it's just free. Judy, what are you talking about the fall for? Okay, because I'm waiting for the summer and the team and all that. But you have to, you're going to prep somewhere along the line if you're going to take a summer vacation. Anybody here going on to some planning a summer vacation? Okay, Joanne, where are you going?
Not sure yet.
Okay. But you're making some kind of preparation. Is that going to be June or July?
Okay.
That's next month, Joanne. Okay,
when
so.
When the kids get out from school.
As soon as they, okay, you're gone. All right, Memorial Day weekend, you're gone. You and everybody else is gone. More track. Okay, so even though I think summer, June 21st, is only 71 or 72 days away, you're making preparations to go away. Like, I'm going on a cruise in August. I'm ready to go now. We have paid it off. It's on Carnival, so I did faster to the fund so we can get there quicker. I didn't spend a lot of money, but we're planning it. I already know what I'm bringing away or how I'm packing and everything, okay? But you're preparing. So now is when you want to start preparing for fall. So who are you talking to? How many shows do you want to do? Okay, Candy and Tammy were just talking about, you know, planting seeds. So those ladies who may, you know, I want to do a show, but summer's so crazy, the kids are home from school, we're going on vacation, some of them may be going on three vacations, I want to go with them, but they're preparing. So what you do now is say, okay, great, I'll give you a call, or when should I give you a call? Do you want me to call you mid-July? Do you want me to call you August? Oh, well, I'm not sure. I'll tell you what, I'll call you after the new catalog comes out. So, on your little, however you do it in your calendar, if you do the weekly thingabob, okay, you go to that, and in mid-August, you put call Jessica, call Joanne, whoever it is. So it's there. So even though someone may be saying, no, I've got graduation coming up, I've got this going on, that's okay. I'll call you whenever. So you are preparing now for the fall. Anybody said no on your surveys? Some of you have heard me say that? So put a little bit on the side. And you tell them to call you. They don't remember, they're so busy. Okay? Let me put your phone down. She can't remember, she put doesn't mean no in 2 months, all right? Iris said never for how many years?
A long time.
Okay. Look what never means, never means never. So you want to prepare now for those that fall. Candy was talking about prospects. You know, so you have prospects for jewelers, but you have prospects for hostesses too. So you always want to have a list going of who, and write in your calendar to call them. Because honestly, I can't tell you what I have. No, I can tell you what I have for breakfast. I can't tell you what I have for dinner last night. Okay, so that's preparing for your fall, because you're going to go through summer and you want to be consistent. So if you only want to do 2 shows a month for the summer, hold 2 shows. If you're going to twice a week, maybe make 15 minutes of phone calls twice a week, make your 15 minutes of phone calls. Don't stop the momentum, because that makes a difference. Because when you stop, you just stop, it's harder to rev up that engine again than if you were just going along. And ladies, what's 15 minutes? Sometimes it takes me 15 minutes to find what I want to watch on TV. Okay, I've got satellite. With all those dang channels, I still can't find anything to watch. Okay, so just be consistent. If you are a brand new jeweler, be consistent. If you are a seasoned jeweler, be consistent. It doesn't matter where you are, whether you're brand new or you're seasoned. you just be consistent. So what night or morning works best for you to make 15 minutes of phone calls? And if you have a family, you got kids running around, go in your bedroom, go outside, put a sign on the door saying, do not disturb, or else. You know, or just let them know that I need 15 minutes. So if you've got little kids, get some jars. Let them decorate some mason jars. Put a hole in the top and say, you let mommy make 15 minutes of phone call, I'm going to put a quarter in your jar. You think they're going to want you to make those phone calls? Okay, because they know that when you are working, they're getting paid immediately, just like us. Okay, so it's a way to get your family involved with what you're doing. If you have older kids, instead of a quarter, give them 75 cents. You're strict tickets to the movies. But what you do now, because fall really does ramp up, because now, and actually, fall isn't October, November.
No.
Fall is August. When those kids go back to school, a switch goes on, Christmas shopping. That was never me in August, like October for me. But a lot of ladies start shopping once the kids go back to school. Once they've gotten the kids' clothes and the whatever they have to get. My son's been out 6 years and they already forgot. So they start thinking. So, and the new jewelry comes out too.
Yes.
It's a great way to show them the new jewelry. And you don't have to, you know, from when I first started to how we do things now, it has changed. But lots of times when ladies hear the word show, in my house, gotta do this, I gotta do that. It's a get together. You know, just let's sit around the kitchen table and let's just play and jewelry.
Right.
As long as you have style sessions, you can do a style session sitting around the table. You know, and playing in jewelry. It doesn't have to be something formal, really formal. You can do it sitting around. But you've gotta start thinking now. So those prospects, whether they're a prospective hostess or they're a prospective jeweler, it's you've got your list. They, just because it's no now doesn't mean in a month or two it's going to be no. You want to have them on your list. And I promise you, if you do that now, you will have a successful fall season, because in the past we've had, they've done it every year since I've been in Premier. In July, they have, I think they've done it July and August, 30, 40, 50. Mm-hmm. So the hostess up to a $300 show, no, up to a $399 show gets the normal 30%. 400 to 499, they get 40%. And 500, they get 50%. So what a great way to have to, for those ladies who said, no, not now. Yeah. Iris, do you want 50% pre-jewelry? Oh. Let's get the gold together. All right, you, wait till you see the new jewelry. It's awesome. I say that all the time, and I said, I know you hear me say it's awesome. How can it always be awesome? It is. It just is. But again, it's always planting those seeds. If you do events, so I've had events, I'm like, why am I here? But I've gotten names because I've done a drawing, and I have found that sometimes those events that are not good when I'm doing them end up being fabulous. You know, I've sponsored from those, so it just depends. But you want to be thinking, and I know it's only 71 days till summer, we're still in spring, it's going to go like that. Mm-hmm. Okay? So you prepare to go to North Carolina, mm-hmm. you prepare to go to California. You're preparing to go someplace. Okay? Prepare now. Even though it seems like it's so far away, you know, I do a countdown for my cruise and wherever, whenever I go on a vacation, my husband and I joke around because we have this countdown clock. And it's like right now, I think it's 3 months, 4 days, and something, whatever, till we go on our cruise. Well, think about it. I'm wishing the summer to go away because it's in August, you know. We're gone when the kids go back to school. Summer's over. So I don't want summer to be over. I just want my Christmas. Does anybody have any questions that I may not have thought about talking about in preparing? Just be consistent. You're going to do it twice a week, do it twice a week. If you do it once a week, just be consistent.
All right. Not here, but I'm going to find it. All right, Brianna. Okay. I'm going to go.
Tools you can use for your business, and Brianna's feeling it, so she'll go ahead and go.
Yeah. So I'm gonna apologize if you can't hear me. I have some sinus issues with losing my voice. So I was asked, why am I watching a training video today? And why have I asked my jewelers, my girls, to watch a training video today, right? So I started thinking about it, and you know, I've been in the business for about 4 or 5 years. And I've just had my highs, I have my lows, and I've just never really been consistent, which is kind of my fault. So I just knew that there was something missing, and I kind of wanted just to kind of dive in this year and really try to absorb as much as I could and really apply it to my goals, which I want to become a builder or designer sometime this year. You know, I had 4 jewelers at one point, but I just didn't qualify to be a builder because I didn't have the shows, which means I didn't do my job, right? So, you know, I definitely wanted to make sure that I was stepping up, kind of getting out of my comfort zone, branching out, and just trying to figure out ways to get motivated and just educate, right? So, I mean, the purpose of this for my jewelers is that way I can lead by example, and that way I could be also a great resource for them, too. So I just wanted to really kind of focus this year on the people, about the women, and just really build some type of value and excitement in these women that I meet, so that way they're as passionate about the jewelry and about the business as I am, which helps with both your hostess and a future prospect if you want to sponsor this, right? So, you know, although I really, really need the money, it's about the people, right? So just building and maintaining those relationships is going to create value for you. And my goal is to try to move these women into the top, right? So, all in all, if I continue to do this, that will be the best effort. Alright. So part of this is about branding, right? And I really like the style shows, or you can call them Trends and Friends. And I like the fact that it's carefree and it can be exciting. So I just kind of wanted to learn more about how to do that. You know, I think the shopping industry is certainly changing. And I think that, you know, direct marketing is definitely going to be our future. So I kind of wanted to be branding myself as doing the style shows and being more consistent. So the key is to be more comfortable with the verbiage. And that's why I'm watching the videos, right? And, you know, just wanting to be able to explain the style show, how to create the simple looks, easiest 1, 2, 3. Making the women I meet confident too, and making it a full circle for them with their outfits, not just about jewelry, which kind of, again, makes it carefree for them. And then, you know, I've just found that as I started doing this, there's a lot of great information. You just gotta take the time. And Candy was mentioning, you know, kind of driving in the car. That's like my time. Or at work, maybe at lunch hour, maybe before work, maybe after work. You just kind of fit it in, right? So I just started looking through, you know, my Facebook groups, YouTube, for some of the jewelers that I want to follow, that I know are doing the same thing that I want to do, as far as style shows, like Jan Francis. Man, I reached out to her the other day. She gave me her time. She was awesome to talk to her on the phone. It wasn't just me watching a video. I was like talking to her about it, and she was encouraging me. So, you know, what I do is I'm just going to try to encourage you ladies to kind of take the time and watch a video, but take notes, go back, read those notes, you know, kind of listen to the video again, because you never know, listening a second time, you might pick up on something that you didn't the first time, which is super important. And then, you know, the more I think that you do this, the more you're comfortable, which is important, which will make you confident. As well as it will come off more natural, and that will become more genuine to the people that you meet, and they're going to really appreciate that. It's not like you're coming off them like a salesperson, which can be very off-putting to some people, but you know, women love it when you're passionate, because it feeds off to them, and then again, you being genuine. So go home, try it. I mean, you've got nothing to lose, and everything can.
Wasn't that great?
Love that.
Understood.
All right. I'm going to do some training on tools here. Candy, while I'm getting set up here, do you want to pass the roll? I forgot to have the sign up and the tickets out for you, so we're going to pass the tickets to you so we can have some prizes. So just take one side. Just take, let the roll go. You want to? Okay. You're just going to pass them out.
Yep.
All right. Never mind then.
She sent us a lot. I
got that ticket right now. All right. So,
this one?
It's this one's Curve Reveal. Fabulous.
Matches the handsome necklace.
Mm-hmm. What she's wearing.
Yeah. Okay, so, when you're planting seeds for your business, one of the things you got to remember too is at your shows, your booking and your retailing and so forth. So a great retailing tool right now, when you're using all of this Facebook technology, she's watching all these videos and so forth, post things. Use that. That's planting seeds to draw people to you. Like I said earlier, if you see an encouraging post, post something like that. That draws people to you. It has absolutely nothing to do with the business, but it draws people to you. And so you can build relationships off of things like that. But if you have a Facebook group, We have, like I have Tammy's Dazzle Divas. Candy has, what is yours, Dewberry Diamond?
Dewberry Diamond.
Dewberry Diamond VIP group. So,
oh yeah.
If you have, if you have a VIP group, don't just post about business all the time. Post other things to keep people's interest, to build that relationship. But one of the things right now, y'all have a great tool the Premier gave us to help with your retail. It's the $10 special. Are y'all using that?
Uh-huh.
Okay, and so one thing that they've changed up that I almost missed is it's not just for shows. It's what? For any order at all.
Individual
Stop
orders.
It.
Yes. Yes.
I have no idea.
It is. I know.
I just found that.
I just saw it. Yeah, so it does not matter where the order comes from. It does not have to be through a show. It's individual orders too. Okay? So you can use your Facebook group and then post something like that, and you do not have to collect a certain amount of orders to qualify a show. If they want it, they get it.
But if you do, you can get yourself some free jewelry by being the hostess and having your own personal Facebook show. So for me, I had a party canceled for this week, and I had one canceled for next Friday. And so I almost had a moment, but I was like, you know what? No, I'm about to still make it happen. So I got on the phone. I made my phone calls to reach out. I'm like, okay, it's the 10th of the month. There's still plenty of time to get ladies on my calendar for the last 2 weeks of April. I will make it happen, and I will do a couple of Facebook parties. So I am very, where did she go? I'm very up on the style session, the closet console, the capsule wardrobe. And if you're on my VIP page, Christine, we are gonna, okay. So y'all might see my ugly closet soon because I'm about to just do the whole thing. And I'm just going to go live, show my closet, and I'm going to turn into a capsule wardrobe, bless my husband, his extra money. So if you're watching, thank you for taking me shopping. I have a capsule wardrobe now, and I finally got me like one of these in every color. He's like, I thought I was just getting you this outfit. But anyways, it's all right. He loves me. Our anniversary is Wednesday. And we won't really probably be together that day because life happens and we're busy. But y'all, okay, we will both be working and it's okay. It's my anniversary, but like, we love each other. We're still married. And it's okay if he does his thing and I do my thing, y'all. It's not the end of the world. Just give your husband a break. Do it a different day. You just make it happen. So anyways, I will be doing some Facebook Live parties. And I have a girl, she's not here tonight, but she's like, well, I've only got 4 shows and I don't think I'm going to hit my quick start. I'm like, call me, why not? Like, we will do a live Facebook party, and you can do, like, a neighborhood, pull some people together. Like, this $75 special, y'all, you can easily get your $100 qualifying order with those if you just put it out there. Test it out on your friends. Go Facebook Live with anybody you know out of town. Add a few select guests. Offer a prize for anyone that adds their friends. Whoever invites the most friends that actually join and going. You know, just get creative if you need some ideas. Try out this fun style thing and just say, hey, I'm going to give it a shot and see what it looks like. Play with the top pieces of jewelry that you may have in your collection. Just show the people that versatility. Just create some type of environment that people are going to want to join. You have fun on my page, right? Like when I do stuff, it's entertaining. So just have fun with them. Be real. Be yourself. But you can get orders that way. And there's no excuse why every single one of us can't do a party on Facebook with your core people. I was telling Alina on the way over here, just take a few people. It doesn't have to be 50 people. Just pick 20 of your like top people you think might order something that you've got on Facebook. Just say, hey, I'm doing this special trial. I'd love your opinion. Let me know what you think. You can all get a $10 gift card just for popping on and, you know, take advantage of this deal.
Can I ask something?
Yeah.
You don't necessarily have to, for yourself, get the jewelry. Mm-hmm. Do it as a mystery hostess.
Yeah. You could do that.
So I did one last month, and the lady who won got $200 in free jewelry.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
So, and if you go on to PennyLacy.com, she did something about Facebook.
Yes, the 10 orders.
And
that was great.
I gave away a gift to the very first order I had gotten. I had an order in 10 minutes. I gave her some. I don't remember what it was.
Yeah, like a dollar per.
And then you can set a limit. So maybe you want 10 orders, or maybe you want 8 orders. So every time you get an order, you place, okay, 5 to go, 6 to go. Mm-hmm. She's got those graphics.
Yeah.
I made my own because she hadn't posted those yet. But you can, when everybody get 10 orders, everybody gets something special. I was going to give everybody who placed orders polishing cloths. I had 10, then I had a lady decided she was going to get an order. Go ahead, Mike.
One thing I will say, too, just for mystery hostess shows, what that means to the new jewelers is everybody that's ordering is put into a drawing, and then you pull one to get the benefits. The only benefit they're allowed, though, is the 30% and the half-price items. They cannot get bonuses because they didn't qualify themselves.
Mm-hmm. Now, okay. If you are doing that show, and you had $100 in pre-orders before that show, you can give yourself.
Yeah, if you're the one doing it and you're doing all the work, that's the thing. Like, for me and Judy and Tammy, we got a ton of jewelry. Like, a stupid amount of jewelry, we don't need any extra jewelry.
Right.
So, like, when I do mine, I buy extra things. So, when I pop on my Facebook group and I do, hey, you know, comment on this, I'm going to give away the blessed necklace for a single mom or whatever. I did mail her that. I had it in stock because I bought extras of certain things when I had free jewelry from doing personal shows. So, like, a brand new jeweler probably going to want to keep that jewelry for their own table, which is fine. But if you want to have the intrigue for some reason, you know, else to get, you know, people involved, say, hey, everybody that orders is going to the drawing for the pot of free jewelry, you know, things
or,
like that.
Or give them half the jewelry, right? If it's
whatever works. Give away the half price items. I've done that too. I've given away the half price items. Yeah.
All right. Cool. So I know y'all are probably thinking, what is all this fun color stuff, right? Okay. So these are some things that I use at my shows to get people to book. Okay. Now, I don't know what booking activity you use, but with all of my girls, we're stacking boxes, okay? Just because it creates a visual of how much free jewelry they can earn. But this does nothing if you don't go and follow up with something to draw them in to get that booking. So you want to give them something to bring them to a point of decision. So around Easter, I like taking around an Easter basket, okay? And instead of everybody's getting a box for player pass, I can't obviously put that many eggs in here unless, well, I could if I took out all of my free stuff. So you could put enough eggs in there. But inside of the eggs are prizes. So they'll take an egg. Okay, ladies, if you want to get some free jewelry, you're going to need to take an egg, and I've got something fun inside there for you. Okay? Who would not want an egg? I know, it's an egg. But who would not want their egg? So they'll take their egg and they'll open it, and like I have for most of my jewelers, you're smarty for having a party, okay? Or there's a mint. Oh, look, you're meant to be a hostess, okay? Or you could do things like a piece of paper that says free shipping, or a clip-it, or something else that you want to do at the show, a charm. Things that are not going to cost you a ton of money to be able to give away. I always encourage things like this for new jewelers that are still paying back their investment because this doesn't really cost you anything and it's fun, okay? But when you do start adding items, free shipping is something very basic. You can give it to them right then. You don't have to keep a pile of prizes, okay? Or you could do polishing cloths. That's less than $2 and you can have those with you. But if you don't have these things, do something that's tangible that you can actually put on their order form right then and there that's going to cost you, you know, $6 or less out of your pocket, okay, but you're getting a booking. Now, one other thing that I do, so I would do this through the Easter season, okay, and yes, we're like a week till Easter, but I have a show this week, so I'm going to take this to my show. So, if y'all got eggs laying around the house in a basket, just throw it together. It doesn't have to be anything fancy.
You can do the same type of thing with the little virtual eggs on Facebook parties.
Okay. And then here's another thing, okay? So it's a cute little plastic flower pot. Y'all, I got it at the dollar store today, okay? And then I just found some fun little flowers that I got three little bushels and then just cut them off, okay? So anyway, I would take this around and say, okay, this will be what I'm using for May, April shower, spring, May flowers. Okay. Ladies, pick your flower, and we'll have them all go around the room. So you could have enough. This could be just like the deal or no deal. Everybody pick a flower, okay? And then on your flower, you're going to find a little piece of paper. Now, you can't look. And you do that. You can't look. Okay. And give them the look. But ladies, now,
when you book your very own girls night or your style show or whatever you want to call it, you're going to get to have whatever is on your flower, okay? And so on this flower, I have a Clip-It, okay? And so that person would get a Clip-It that night. It would cost me $6, okay? You could do, like I said, the free shipping and whatever you want it to be on there. Or you could do something like $25 in free jewelry. They get it at their show. It does not cost you anything until they hold the show. And it's not going to hurt you to pay that $12.50 that is your half when you actually have a show that, because they're a fun little flower or whatever, they got on your calendar. Okay? Now, I also, this one, I did, this is what I will be using. So, actually, underneath all my flowers, I have retired pieces of jewelry or jewelry that I just want to move. Okay? And so, instead of having something on my flowers, I'll just take my flowers out. And I'll say, you know, you can go dig through here and you can pick any piece of jewelry that you like and I will bring it to your show. Same thing. I haven't lost anything if they haven't done a show for me. So for the ones of us that have been around for a while, we do have this jewelry that we can do this with.
Lots of jewelry.
Lots of jewelry. And so use your jewelry to your benefit. Okay? Doing a show can build a business in a whole different direction. So if it means you get rid of a piece of jewelry, then you get rid of a piece of jewelry, okay? Now, so that's all kind of fun stuff to book your calendar, and I would like to give this to Brianna for training for us tonight.
Yay!
You're welcome. So if you have any questions about stuff like that, just draw them in, do something fun, it gets them excited, and we're girls, so we like pretty stuff, okay? And if you build your calendar, that's what we'll do, okay?
You're blurry.
Oh, she's blurry. So I think that's about it, except for our announcement. Sam's going to do them. Did you tell her?
Sam,
you're doing announcement.
He's trying to trick me, too.
Oh, don't worry, Sam.
Don't worry. I was like, oh, I don't know anything.
I didn't tell her she was doing announcements. I told her she was doing the rally part.
Yeah, that's part of announcements.
No, it's not.
Here. It's all right. It's just talking about rally.
So it's very simple.
Okay. So you kind of got to explain your how you're getting there, what you're doing on the way. Your mindset,
right.
Like me.
All right, so rally registration is coming soon. Who plans to go?
Who's going? Y'all raise your hands.
Yes.
I'm giving birth.
Excellent. Yeah.
She's due. She's due today.
What did she ask?
Who's going to rally?
Oh, I want to.
Yes. Yes. That's no, good. Yes. Starts with a plan. There you go.
All right, so.
Can you get me off of work?
Girl, I can't send a sick note. Okay.
Yeah,
okay,
so Sam wants to tell you all this excitement here.
Okay, so now for our rally story. All right, well, I know last year was my first year. I've been in Premier for about a year and a half now. So Candy was like, you're going. And I'm like, I can't go. She's like, you're going. And I went. And I loved it. Yeah, I didn't want to fly. And so I went. And I won't miss one again. Forever. And so my husband's really excited this year. We have our it's an apple juice because we put all the coins in it. We're gonna get all of it. Mm-hmm. So we have a jar of coins that we're just stocking up, and that's gonna be our rally money. I know that they do the, what is it, Dimes for Dallas is one of them.
No, Dollars.
The little, or Dollars to Dallas. It's money in the
oh
jar.
Yeah, the Dimes to Dallas. Yeah, 2 liter bottle.
Yeah. So, last year, with it being my first year, it was there. It's a lot to take in, but it kind of brings you to a whole nother, like, understanding of Premier. Everybody says, well, it's not just the jewelry. It's not just the jewelry. And I'm like, okay. So I go there, and it's really not just the jewelry. It was good to hear of the ladies who were up there. They told you about how they failed and then how they, you know, were successful. So that's the other thing. You see, like, you know, you see Tammy and Candy and Judy, and you know they've been here for a long time, and they're very successful, but it wasn't always like that, so that was good to know that I got through that one hump, and then it kind of plateaued, and I'm like, okay, but it helped me to kind of continue, and so.
But explain what you are not letting be an excuse for you.
Kids.
Oh, yeah. You just had a what?
Oh, yeah, I just had a baby. Yeah, I just had a baby in January, so.
And her kids are going with her.
Yes, they're going with us. We're going to drive. So, y'all pray for us.
planning to do jewelry shows on the road.
Yes, so we have, because my kids are going with, I've a longtime family friend who's in New Orleans, so I've been talking with her about doing a show on her way in, and then I have a friend who actually lives in Fort Worth, so after Raleigh's over, go back.
That's my girl!
And, you know, once you go, like Sam said, you just won't miss again. You understand what it is.
It's so hard that all day,
she almost delivered. She was at the point of delivering a baby, and I took a 12-week-old because he was playing around Rally. Y'all,
and
that's how crazy it is.
That's the first thing I said about Rally. First baby, we sitting on the, they got me on the whatever that chair thing is, and I'm like, can I fly in July? Like, that was my first question to my daughter. She's like, be careful, you're going to offend Steven. I'm like, what can I? And then they said, no, I have to drive. And so we were driving. Like, we were all set to drive. And then we switched midwives. And she's like, well, I'd actually prefer you fly. I was pulling out the Kaiser parking lot on the phone with Delta. Okay, and me and Steven had drove separate cars. So I booked two
That's
days.
How impactful Rally
you
is.
Do not miss Rally. So I've never missed
If there's
rally.
Any way to get there, we always
Unless you're, like,
you
having the baby.
Encourage you to try to get there, for sure.
Mother. Crash your hotel room.
Just so you know, kids cannot go to Rally. She will have her husband to be able to watch the kids and then come back and forth during break time.
Yeah, they come into like the meal area and they actually, so they even actually added like a nursing room and like a pump, like moms can like nurse and pump and all that. So they're like phenomenal as far as that goes to make it as.
And when you're in that nursing room, you're not missing anything.
No.
They have a big TV, so you see everything that's going on.
So are you there for like tickets then? Did you drawings?
Yes.
Yes. They must have somebody back there.
You're there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, what are the rest of our announcements? All right, so next one is, so it's the $10 special through April 30th. Mm-hmm. And then the next thing is the next fund to share is April 24th. And training is May 8th. And then there is a mother-daughter tea to be determined.
Yes.
Yeah, I had the
Okay, so we're going to do some prizes. And you want to get something to comment?
Before we do prizes, I'm going to pass out some seeds.
Oh. Whenever I remember this training tonight, and Galatians 6:9 is on here, so y'all remember.
Yay. So I'm going to pass these around. Everybody take a seed packet so you can remember what you learned here tonight. And always focus on planning. No, they're different ones, so just
pick whichever.
The bus. I have not heard anything about the bus this year. I'm telling y'all right now. Flight to like 2:30 and work every day. We're looking right now for like 2:32.
I'm exhausted.
We called in February last year. I mean, so you can book any.
I've already cried.
Here's the thing: the best way to split Rally for going. Book your airfare now. Right, so you pay an airfare. You know, sometimes we do March, April, whatever. Some people get it in May, but anyway, so you book your airfare now. Then you pay your Rally registration for $165. You pay that usually end of May or June, and then you don't pay your hotel until you actually get there, which will be, you know, July, almost 23rd
July.
So that way you split it, and we room like four to a room. We have a blast. Like,
But you know what? You really are not smoking in there. It's more. And you split it. Some people will do two. It's up to you.
You can. We can do five. We bring it here.
Yeah, you can do what you want. Who wants the, you know, the comfort? Once Rally's registration comes, we really want to try to get a list of who's trying to go, because we try to get rooms in the same vicinity if at all possible. So that way we can start planning with you to have Rally buddies and things like that.
And if you're watching online,
it's roughly
plan to be a Rally.
Depending on what you're pricing on the airfare and things like that, it's roughly between $500 and $600 to go. It's all a write-off, and it's the best investment you will ever make in your business. You will come back making money.
Yeah, it is like putting money in your pocket. Alright, ready for prizes?
Not to mention, you get to see the jewelry first.
Oh, yeah. And you get a discount on the jewelry. You get an extra 30% off.
Okay, so this person gets a prize. Last three numbers, 5, 3, 8. Let me show you your prizes, y'all. This is fun.
538.
Look, Judy. You can have some gloves to plant with.
She don't want frog.
Or you can have a frog or a ladybug. These are wind chimes, and they have things. Frog or ladybug wind chime. Or you can have one of these to go in your yard.
Oh,
okay, what do you like,
Judy?
I want a wind chime.
I'm not going to say that. She said she gonna want the frog as soon as I saw the frog.
Oh, y'all.
Don't let go.
Oh, man.
Don't let go.
Woo, Dylan.
He said my frog.
Dylan, you want this? You want one?
You have
no.
Don't tease them with that. You're going to do it.
All right. Yard art, y'all.
Yard art. Yard art.
Okay.
Yard.
Next winner. Or you can have the last 3, 5, 4, 3.
Oh,
who's
after me?
Yay! What would you like? Some gardening gloves, a wind chime, or a garden?
Some gloves.
Which one?
Green gloves. Green gloves.
Which one?
Red.
Right,
you got.
Oh, she's cheating now.
She has the box instead of the toy.
Okay, we got 2, 5, 4, 1, and 5, 4, 4.
Hey, that's one.
Yay!
Yay!
I knew you were
going to
say
that.
Who else
wants to say
5, 4, 2?
No.
5, 4, 4.
5, 4, 4.
I just entertain
myself.
Okay, I guess they maybe
they're
simple entertainment.
She gone. There's
nobody left.
Gone.
No one left.
Bar.
Yeah.
Bar. No, the tickets were after that.
I didn't get a ticket.
No, no one or something, so that's not a ticket, though.
She has a ticket.
4, 5, 4, 4. Tammy, did you read it correctly?
5, 4, 1. That was me. 5, 4, 1 was the other one.
5, 4, 1.
Oh, that's me.
Oh, yeah.
What would you like? Gloves or a yard art?
Or an egg.
You should have worn
an egg.
What color game would you like?
Any color.
Green, pink.
It's going to be lucky because candy touched it.
Oh, yeah.
We have three more eggs.
Okay.
And two of these.
You want these?
You're not yard guard
anymore.
I know.
I'm not
sure.
Sign up
under 5, 4, 8.
Oh, that's me.
What would you like? An egg or one of these? I do not come with, but
but who's gonna do that in my yard?
You get a dancing gnome.
Y'all, I was actually gonna get a little hoe.
Sorry.
Right.
All right, 5, 4, 6.
Yeah,
it's all around me.
You want an egg or two eggs?
Yard
art,
I guess.
Yard art.
I'm
thinking
about
that. We're gonna say this
one
for
Ellen.
I grew up with them little things.
We got three more eggs.
What?
Because I can have this in my house.
Oh, Dylan wants it.
5, 4, 2.
Okay.
Okay.
What egg would you like?
I'll do the
pink. Dylan has a girlfriend.
Oh yeah, I hope for a girl.
No, Dylan can have a girlfriend.
What a girl?
Everybody stand up,
this is how rally works. Keep standing if the first number is 8.
Woo!
I don't know.
Yeah, everybody's no. Okay, seven. So at rally, everybody stands up and you know we're not playing that. You sit down
and it's not. I looked inside.
Thank y'all all for coming tonight. We hope you learned a lot. Hopefully we didn't scare you away.
Tammy, you want to end being live?
I don't know how, otherwise I would.